Hey, it's Fran, again, in the vault, and today I'm pulling out random box of junk. This comes from the University of Pennsylvania. It originally had computer boards, ink, stuff in it, but yeah, this came from their lab. It's just a box labeled MISC IDE, so I would take a look. This is... This is kind of typical of the kind of stuff that I got from the University of Pennsylvania. It's just a, it's a box of stuff. Jamco stuff. Oh, I got some tricolor LED, bicolor and, are they tricolor? Well, I guess they'd be considered tricolor because you'd have two LEDs in there and be a mix of red and green, and you'd have orange or yellow or something. But yeah, tricolors. Stuff like, whoa. This. Oh, that's really something. That's some kind of air pressure gauge. Center ring. Okay, yeah. Look at that. So that centers it. You got a piston in there. And a precision kind of switch. Is that a switch or a potentiometer? It goes to something. I don't know. I guess that used to turn. Okay, so that used to be a... used to turn an assembly. Yeah. Well, that's pretty cool. Whatever that used to do. Random homemade board. Yeah, wire wrapped. Yeah, that's something. WE057, that's 1979, so we're going back a ways here. 1979 wire wrapped board. Ugh. That's all leaked out. Yeah. No good anymore. Probably shouldn't be going through this with my bare hands. DC to DC converters. New old stock. Yep. Pretty straightforward. Might probably still work. If I had the spec sheet for the pinout, you know, maybe that would still work. Lots of random chips. 1985 on that one. So that looks like a... what is that? Is that a socket? Some kind of socket. Big ass heatsink. Looks like for a TO5 case transistor. Yep. Looks like some of the battery squidge got on that. Ugh. Another board. Tangled up mess. Another board. Codes on there. Oh, upside down. The electrons will fall out. Yep, RCA. Yep. Another D-Day converter. Ooh, look at that. Little side. Ooh, gold side pins. Look at that. Oh. I don't see that these days so much. 1985 again, so. Yeah, selected 12AX7 tube. Okay. Yep. Selected. Selected tube. Unfortunately, we have no way of knowing exactly what specs that was selected to. It's an ECC. Telefunken. We'll just keep that in the box for future generations. Oof. It's just a big. That's a big module. Some big octal socket thingy. Is that a Motorola brand? 7142. It's a 1971. It's probably a solid-state rectifier. And they were just had it with this kind of cool bench socket. Made in the USA, of course. Can't read that. Pomona Electronics in Pomona, California. Yep. So it's a solid-state replacement for a tube rectifier. We're using that for a rectifier. That's what they did back in the day. I have no idea what that is. It's like some kind of spring-loaded something. It had a little rubber wheel on the end at one point. You know, it's just an aluminum thingamajigger. Who knows what that was for? I do not know, but there are several of them in here. The old ubiquitous Magnetec transformer. Wire wrap. This is funny because I made a point in the original video when I did that haul that I was using recycled Magnetec transformer boxes to hold little parts, and I found an identical one there, and they were doing the same thing. Yep, wire wrap all the way, baby. Yep. Yep, Magnetec transformer boxes. You never want to throw them out. There's another big converter. They really like these flat pack converters. Ah, vintage. Radio Shack Archer parts, infrared emitter and detector. And of course on the back you get all of the specs that you need. Oh, I really miss those days. You could just go into the store, pick it right off the rack, whatever you need. Ah, nostalgia. Pinhole adapter. Ugh. Gross. That is just a mess. It's got that oily foam in there. Ugh. Ugh, ugh, ugh.
Yeah.
Eek. Yep. Yep, that's all it is. Just these little metal things in there. Pinhole adapters. So I guess those are for optics. Yeah, see, they're all sized. They're all just encased in goo now, but yeah, that was for an optical thing, you know, for a lamp assembly. You know, pinhole for a pinhole camera or a pinhole projector. Some kind of data thing for something. Sylvania pilot light. Yep. That's how you'd get them. Yep. Ooh. Yep. It's got no tip on it, but. Newish in box. Erg. Ooh. Oh, the pin light. Is there a... What do I see in there? Looks like a filament. It's wild. Something in there. I don't know. A lot of other stuff. Some vintage LEDs pulled out of something. This looks like a pool. Super vintage. Well, a little adventure of a typical box of stuff from a typical 70s, 80s era lab. Just, you know, stuff you'd keep around and if you ever wanted to use it again. Stuff for other projects. Wire wrap, you name it. All right, well, thanks for coming with me on this voyage of discovery, and thanks to all the patrons down on the Patreon. Wouldn't be able to do any of this without my patrons. So thank you, thank you, thank you. If you like what I do, consider becoming a patron. Just follow the link in the description, and I will thank you personally. All right, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back at the lab real soon.
Work. In the lab. Go berserk. In my lab. It's where I work. Yeah.